Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I want to show you how to export high-quality TikTok videos using Adobe Premiere Pro. But to save you time, if you don't want to watch me ramble through this entire tutorial, you can click the link down in the video description to download my TikTok export presets completely for free to save you time and get you exporting immediately. Alternatively, if you want to watch my entire exporting process, keep watching this video. Let's jump right into Adobe Premiere. Welcome to Premiere Pro. I've already imported some footage here. It's a time lapse. And the first thing you're going to notice is, Matt, this time lapse is horizontal. TikTok is vertical. Yes, we'll be modifying this video to fit the vertical TikTok format. Let's start by creating a new sequence by pressing Control in on PC or Command in if you're on a Mac to bring up the new sequence dialog box. Going through the sequence presets, go to Digital SLR, 1080p, DSLR 1080p 24, and then click settings at the top. All of these settings are good. The only thing that we need to change is the frame size. We're gonna change the horizontal frame size to 1080 and the vertical frame size to 1920. Now let's go down and click save preset so we don't have to make this preset again. Alternatively, you could download my TikTok export presets, link down in the description. Let's title this preset TikTok 1080 x 1920 23.976. So that way we know the resolution and the frame rate. Click OK to save this as a preset. And with the preset selected, let's go down here to sequence name and let's name this TikTok time lapse. Hit OK. Next, I'm gonna go up here and select my time lapse video clip and drag it down to the timeline. Whenever the clip mismatch warning comes up, I'm gonna click keep existing settings. And ooh, look at that. Suddenly we got a vertical video over here. This time lapse does not fit the frame though. So I'm gonna go down here and click on the video clip. Then I'm gonna go up here to the effect controls tab and under scale, I'm gonna click and drag to the right and that's gonna make the video clip bigger. That looks good for scaling. Remember, your main goal is that you do not want any black bars on the top or bottom of your video clip. To reframe your horizontal video, you can go up here to position and where it says 540, you can click and drag left and that's gonna pan things left. Drag right, pan things right. Let's now say that I'm done editing this video and I'm ready to export it. I'm gonna go to the start of the video clip and I'm gonna press I to set my endpoint for the video where Premiere knows where to start exporting. Then I'm gonna drag over here to the last part of the video clip or you can press down to go directly to the end and I'm gonna press O to set the out point. Next, press Control M if you're on PC or Command M if you're on Mac to bring up the export settings dialog box. For format, you're gonna wanna make sure that you've selected H.264. For preset, you could literally select anything because we're gonna customize it all, but if you have it available, click Match Source High Bitrate. Next, click on Output Name, and this is where you're gonna save your rendered video file. So make sure that you put this in a place where you can get to it because you're gonna need to know where your video file is later. In this case, I'm gonna call it TikTok Timelapse, and click save here in the renders folder. Next, make sure that export video and export audio are checked. And let's go down here to the video tab. Under basic video settings, you're gonna wanna make sure that your width is 1080 and your height is 1920. If it is not that, you can click this little checkbox here and then you can begin to make changes to the width and the height. But because this is already done, I can click this checkbox and it's already locked in. For frame rate, you want 23.976. Click this checkbox if you need to change that. Field order progressive, aspect square pixels, NTSC. Make sure that render at maximum depth is checked. This is gonna result in a higher quality video for you. Moving on down to encoding settings. For performance, software encoding is fine. If you have hardware encoding, it may be a little bit faster. For profile, make sure it's set to main, and for level, make sure it's set to 4.1. Rolling on down here, you do not need to worry about any of these settings until we get down to bitrate settings. These settings right here are one of the most important parts of the exporting process. They're gonna have a major impact on the quality of your video. Click the bitrate encoding dropdown, and you're gonna see you have a few options, either VBR or CBR. VBR stands for variable bitrate. Think of the bitrate as the quality of your video. The computer is pretty good at guessing how high the bitrate needs to be to make sure the video looks good, but sometimes it isn't perfect, so the quality isn't so good. In contrast, you have a CBR, which stands for constant bitrate, which is essentially you telling the computer, I always want the bitrate to be high, I want this to be the highest quality possible. So I'm gonna select CBR because I want to guarantee high quality. And then for the target bitrate, I'm gonna set that to 15 megabits per second. You don't need to worry about these last two things, but make sure that you check the use maximum render quality box because that will make a difference. Next, let's go up to the audio tab. And for audio format, I'm gonna select AAC, Audio codec AAC, sample rate 48,000 hertz, channel stereo, audio quality high, bitrate 320, with a precedence for bitrate. Let's now save these settings as an export preset so you don't have to type them all in the next time you want to export your video. Go up here to preset and click this little down arrow that says save preset. And let's call this TIK TOK. 1080x1920, 23.976 FPS, 15 Mbps CBR. That way we can see all the settings right there. And let's click OK. Go down here to the bottom and you can click export if you want to immediately begin exporting your video in Adobe Premiere, or you can do it how I prefer to do it and click Queue, which is going to send this video project to Adobe Media Encoder. Adobe Media Encoder will now open, and as you can see, here is the video project, and you can click the green play button to start exporting the video. You can then minimize Adobe Media Encoder and go back to Adobe Premiere. This video is now finished, and you can go up and click the blue text under the output file, and that will open up the folder where your video clip is saved. To upload your video to TikTok, go to tiktok.com, log in, go up to the cloud icon in the top right, and click upload video. Open the folder where your video is saved and click and drag your video to the select video to upload box. Next, write a caption for your video. Cool time lapse, bro. Click and drag through to select a cover. Make sure these settings look good and then click post and your video is on TikTok. Now there is one last thing you need to know. As I said at the start of this video, my goal is to help you upload high quality videos to TikTok. The issue is that TikTok can sometimes be inconsistent with the quality that it will convert your videos to when you upload. Sometimes they stay at 1080 by 1920 at 15 megabits per second, like we've set up here. But sometimes TikTok will reduce the video's quality down, with the lowest quality I've seen being 576 by 1024. This sucks, and after uploading over 50 test videos to TikTok, the only reason that I can come up for why this is occurring is that there may be too many people using the app at the same time, so TikTok isn't able to put all of these videos up at the highest quality. So how do you avoid that? How do you keep your video quality high? My recommendation to you is to upload your video privately to TikTok and then use your phone to download the video. Then send the video file to your computer using AirDrop, Google Drive, or Dropbox, and then use VLC Media Player to check the video's resolution and bitrate. If it matches 1080 by 1920 at approximately 10 to 15 megabits per second, you're good. If not, I would try re-uploading your video to TikTok and seeing if the quality is improved. With that, you now know how to export high quality videos for TikTok from Premiere Pro. If you haven't downloaded those presets yet and you want to, they are still linked down in the video description. It would also be a huge help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.